Welcome back. Mina police have issued a look notice against Rajesh Naik and Jayesh Naik in the Sultan Bellary murder case. Police had earlier arrested three suspects in this case. A search for the missing head is still on.
Mina police on Saturday issued lookout notice against Rajesh Naik and Jayesh Naik. Earlier, the police had arrested three more persons in this murder case. Another person was interrogated on Friday. A search for the missing head is still on. Sources have hinted at few more arrests. Sultan Bellary was beheaded by unknown persons on 11 January at Davoli in San Jose de Arial. A Maruti van, a scooter, used in committing the offence is also seized. The motive behind the murder is still not clear. Police have also seized a vehicle in which the body was allegedly carried and thrown at Davoli. Our reporter in Kuttori, Samir Bhatt.
Inflow of remittances from NRIs to Goa amount to around 800 crores annually. NRI Commissioner Eduardo Folero mentioned this figure at a NRI conference. The conference was organized by Central Bank of India for completing 100 years of its services.
Central Bank of India celebrated its 100 years of banking services in Goa by organizing an NRI conference. The event was graced by Chief Minister Digambar Kamath and Commissioner for NRI Affairs Eduardo Folero. Other officials from the bank were present on the occasion. Folero spoke on the volume of remittance from abroad.
The remittances from Goan migrants to this state are in the rate of 800 crores thereabouts per year. More or less 800 crores per year. Mostly they are remitted through the banks, majority of it, and partially, to a much smaller extent, through postal services, through the post, courier, and things of the sort. Friends and relatives who come to Goa, then money is sent with them. And sometimes the migrant himself brings the money here. So that is the way the money comes here.
With nearly 200 crores of business in Goa, Central Bank of India is tying up with the state government to provide more services to the people. They also plan to expand their footprint in the state.
For instance, e-governance is a new scheme wherein present Chief Minister is having a concentrated focus. There also we are cooperating and entering into a joint venture with the government of Goa.
Our reporter Jason Suarez with video journalist Shan.
Village Group of Goa has raised the issue of illegal shipyards operating along the banks of Zuari River. They claim the shipyard is operating without proper permissions from the authorities. The group is upset as the yard is operating right in the constituency of Environment Minister Alexio Siqueira.
The thing is that it's absolutely illegal. They don't have any permissions from any authority, but they're just operating with the blessings of the politicians. And what another thing to note is that this is happening right in the constituency of the Environment Minister, Mr. Alexio Siqueira. All these illegal shipyards are operating in his constituency. And we don't know with whose blessings they're operating.
The Village Group of Goa had organized a boat ride for media persons and the villagers of Kuttari and Lotholi. They showed them the illegal shipyards operating along the banks of River Zuari. The members' group claimed that these shipyards are operating without proper permission from the competent authorities.
They don't have anything from the CRZ, no approvals of the CRZ at all. So they're just operating, and besides that, they're operating in tenanted paddy fields without any conversions or anything at all. So, and the captain of ports has illegally issued them some license to carry on the activity so that they can build some dry docks and jetties and all that.
Zarina Dacunia, a member of Village Group of Goa, claims shipyards have been expanded by cutting mangroves.
What is more hurtful is cutting the mangroves and reclaiming the area from the river and calling it a dockyard or a barge building area, which is very, very wrong and outright illegal.
A PIL has been filed in this connection at the Bombay High Court in Panaji praying for closure of the illegal shipyards set along the banks of Zuari River. The hearing for the same has been scheduled on 24 January. While they were moving by sea, their boat got stuck in between the Zuari River due to low tide. Later, marine police and a fishing trawler rescued them. A reporter from Kuttari, Surendra Madkekar.
Sankwal residents have strongly opposed the illegal cutting of mangroves. It is suspected that the mangroves are being chopped down for some project in the area. People claim a person by the name Chogule plans to set up a marina project.
Some unknown persons were found illegally cutting the mangroves. As per environment protection law, any person involved in cutting of mangroves is liable for a civil penalty. Most of the villagers in Sakwa have been using this place for fishing and other purposes. They fear that this beautiful and scenic place would vanish if chopping down mangroves is not stopped. They further suspect a person by name Achyut Naik in this illegality.
आणि त्यांना आमचे गावचे पंचायत फोन मारलो तुळशीदासाक आणि त्याक सांगले असे असे हिंगा उभं राहा आपण म्हणाल तो रोकडं पोलीस कंप्लेन करता आणि फॉरेस्टाकूय सांगून देत म्हणून.
2 years back, some unknown person tried to cut the mangroves, but they were stopped. Acting Sarpanch Ramakant Borkar along with other panch members visited the site. They claimed there was no application for any project nor for cutting the mangroves. Panchayat now intends to complain to the police and the forest department against this illegal act.
ना अजून प्रोजेक्ट तरी आमच्या पुढ्या नजर येईल ना, पण हे कटिंग करतेजर आम्ही कोणा काय सांगोना.
आमचा जो गावचो जो आपण गाव बरं करपा म्हणून चित्ता, कितें गाव कसो बरं करतलो म्हणून म्हाका खबर ना, पण तोच एक 4-5 लोकांक घेवन, ताचें नांव अच्युत नायक, कितें तो फुडें सरला आनी 4-5 भुरग्यांक घेवन तो हांगा ताणें कांय न्हू म्हणल्यार अर्दें कापलां.
A reporter from Sakwa, Surendra Madgaikar.
News from sports when we come back from a short break. Stay tuned.